Hello everyone, myself Mrs. Sonali Dev. I welcome you to my channel Dev's Institute. I am starting with series of discrete structure lecture, and here is my first lecture from discrete structure subject, that is permutation. Before I start, I request you to subscribe to my channel by clicking subscribe button given below the video and click on bell icon to get instant notification about the videos. Definition: an arrangement in a sequence of elements of a set is called as permutation. Permutation is applied where order of an element is important. So, if you want to arrange the elements of a set in a particular order, then we can apply permutation to check the number of possible different sequences. Before we actually start with problems of permutation, you must know the rule of sum and product. What is rule of product? If one experiment has m outcomes and other has n outcomes, then there are total m by n possible outcomes when both of these experiments takes place. Rule of sum: if one experiment has m outcome and other has n outcome, then there are total m plus n possible outcomes when either of these experiments takes place. So when both of the experiment takes place, we multiply the outcome of the two experiment to get the final outcome, and if either of the experiment takes place, then we add the outcomes of the two experiment to get the final outcome or total outcome of the experiment. To get more clear idea of this, we'll see one example. Consider there are 50 ways to select CR of SE and 30 ways to select CR of TE. Then how many total ways are there to select CR of SE and CR of TE? So here we have to select one CR from SE and one CR from TE. So the total number of ways will be equal to 50 into 30, and that is equal to 1500 ways, because here both of the experiments will take place. One CR from SE is selected and one CR from TE is selected. Now the second example: if there are 50 ways to select CR of SE and 30 ways to select CR of TE, then how many total ways are there to select CR from SE or TE? So now we have to select only one common CR from SE or TE. So here total number of ways are 50 plus 30, that is equal to 80. Now we'll see the formula of permutation. Consider we have to place 3 balls, red, blue and white, in 10 boxes. So we have 10 boxes and we have 3 balls. So to place first red ball, we have total 10 boxes, that is 10 possible outcomes are there. So the total number of outcomes to place red ball is 10. So red ball will be placed in one of the 10 boxes. Then for second ball, that is blue ball, you have only 9 options remaining. So for second experiment you have total 9 outcomes, and as both of the experiment takes place, so 10 multiplied by 9. In third white ball case, you have only 8 boxes remaining, that's why total number of ways to place white ball is 8. So the total outcome is equal to 10 into 9 into 8. In general, if there are n boxes and if there are r balls, then total number of possibilities to place r balls in n boxes is given by n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 up to n minus r plus 1. And this gives us the formula for permutation. So permutation of n objects taken r at a time is given by npr, which is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial, where n is the number of objects and R is the number of places. Basically, there are four types of problems asked from the permutation, of the permutation. First one is when all objects are distinct. Second is when all objects are not distinct. In this case, it is considered whether the repetition of the object is allowed or not. Third case is repetition of object is allowed. And fourth is when objects are to be arranged in a circle. Out of which the first method is very common. And so in this video we'll only focus on the first method, that is when all objects are distinct. In my next video of permutation, we'll focus on rest of the three categories of the problems. Here is the first example from permutation. In how many ways three examinations can be held in 5 days? So here it is very straightforward example. N is equal to number of days is equal to 5. R is equal to number of examinations is equal to 3. So NPR gives us the value of permutation, or the total number of possible outcomes, that is equal to 60. Example 2. Find the permutation of a set A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, taking elements 2 at a time. So here N is equal to total number of elements, that is equal to 4. And R is the length of each number to be formed, that is equal to, total number of elements 4. And R is length of the each number to be formed, that is equal to 2. So just put this N and R in NPR and you get the result as 12. Okay. Example 3. Find how many words of length 3 can be formed from the word computer, the beginning letter being C and no repetition is allowed. So now here total number of letters are 7. And from these 7 letters, we have to form a word of length 3, out of which the first letter is fixed, and that is C. So here, out of 3 letters, first letter is fixed, C. So to select a letter at a second position, you have 6 choices, because here C is already placed at a first position. So you have total 6 choices for second position. So 7, computer is total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 letter word. So it is C is here. So you have total 7 choices for the second position. So it is equal to 7P1. So one of the 7 letter will be selected to be placed over here. So you have 6 choices for the third position. So total number of possibilities will be 7 into 6, that is equal to 42. 7P1 is 7 and 6P1 is equal to 6. So 7 into 6 and that is equal to 42 words. Example number 4. Find how many codes can be formed if the first 2 symbols are letters and next 3 are digits, but no symbol is repeated. So here first 2 symbols are letters. So first symbol can be selected from 26 letters by 26P1 ways. As the one letter is selected here, you have only 25 choices at the second place, which will be selected by 25P1 ways. To place the digits, you have to form the 3 digits. So first digit has 10 choices, second digit has 9 choices, and third digit has 8 choices. So 10 into 9 into 8. Alternatively, we can do it by using 26P2. So we have to select 2 letters from 26 letters, 26P2 multiplied by 10P3. So total number of words equal to 26P2 multiplied by 10P3. Example 5. How many different ways are there to arrange the letters in the word problem if the letter P must come first, second, the letter P must come first and M last. So here in first case, the first letter is fixed, that is P, and now we have to arrange the rest six letters. Rest six letters by which can be done by using 6P6 ways, that is nothing but the 6 factorial. Here the first letter is fixed P, and these 6 letters can be arranged in themselves by using 6P6 ways. The second condition is the letter P must come first and letter M last. So here letter P is fixed, first letter is fixed, last letter is fixed. So in between we have to arrange the remaining 5 letters amongst them, which can be done by 5P5 ways, which is equal to 5 factorial. Example 6. Suppose that repetitions is not allowed, then how many 4-digit numbers can be formed from digit 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8? How many numbers in 1 are less than 4000? How many numbers are even, and how many numbers in 1 contains both digits 3 and 5? So we'll solve this one by one. First is, how many 4-digit numbers can be formed from these 6 digits? So it is very straightforward, and we have to select 4 digits from the 6 digits. So 6P4, and that is equal to 360. The second is, how many numbers in 1 are less than 4000? In 1 means we have to select digit from these numbers and you have to form a number with a 4 digits. Okay, so here numbers starting with 1, 2 and 3 are less than 4000. Okay, so numbers starting with 1. So here first number is fixed. Out of this 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, first number is fixed and that is 1. So for rest 3 numbers, we have to select the numbers from these remaining 5 numbers, which can be done using 5P3 ways. Okay, I repeat, number starting with 1 is the first digit is fixed, that is 1. So out of this, this 1 will be placed at a first position, and these remaining 5 numbers are used to place or to select the numbers for rest of the 3 digits. So the 3 digits selected for the next 3 digits from these 5 numbers is given by 5P3 ways, that is equal to 60. Similarly, number starting with 2. So first digit is fixed, that is 2, and we have to select rest 3 numbers from the remaining 5 numbers, and which will be done by 5P3 ways, 60. Number starting with 3, again the first digit is fixed and rest 3 digits will be selected from the remaining 5 digits, that is equal to 60. So here either number starting with 1 or 2 or 3 will be less than 4000. So 60 plus 60 plus 60, that is equal to 180. Next is, how many numbers in 1 are even? So again the numbers are 4 digit numbers formed from 1, 2, 3, 5 and 7, 8. So here number ending with 2 and 8 are even. Okay, so number ending with 2, again last digit is fixed and we have to select the first 3 digits from the remaining 5 digits, which will be done by 5P3 ways, that is equal to 60. Number ending with 8, again the 8 is fixed and first 3 digits are selected by using 5P3 ways, that is equal to 60. So numbers 4 digit numbers, even numbers, is equal to 60 plus 60, that is equal to 120. Last question, sub question. How many numbers in 1 contains both digit 3 and 5? Okay, so the number 4 digit number must contain the letter digit 3 and digit 5. So to place digit 3, we have total 4 options, 4 places. Out of these 4 places, one place is selected by 4P1 ways. Okay, then to place 5, we have 3 options. So 3P1 ways are, 3P number of ways are there to place the number 5. So this is to arrange the 3 and 5 in 4 digit number. Then we have selected the 2 digit, that is 3 and 5, and we have placed them in a digit. Now it's time to select the 3rd digit. So out of total 6 digit, 3 digits are already chosen. So we have only 4 choices. So out of those 4 choices, 1 digit is selected for the 3rd position, and the remaining, from the remaining 3 digits, 1 digit is selected for the last position. Okay, so this is to arrange 3 and 5, and this is to select the other 2 numbers from the given numbers, that is 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8. So that is equal to 144. Okay, the last example, 6 different mathematics books, 4 different DS books and 3 different computer science books are to be arranged on a shelf. How many different arrangements are possible if the books in each subject must all be together? Second, only the DS books must be together. So we'll consider first sub question. The books in each subject must all be together. So these are 6 maths books, these are 4 DS books, and these are 3 computer science books. Okay, so here all the condition is that the books of every subject must be together. So we'll consider this group of 6 books as a 1 unit, this books of 4 books as second unit, and this books of 3 groups as a 3rd unit. Now the maths books can be arranged in themselves by using 6P6 ways. DS books can be arranged in themselves by using 4P4 ways, and CS books can be arranged amongst themselves by 3P3 ways. Okay, so this is for arranging books within themselves. Now we can place these maths books here, DS books here, or maths books at the last, DS then CS, or CS first then DS then maths. So likewise, these 3 subjects can be arranged in themselves by 3P3 ways. So this is for arranging maths books among themselves, this is for arranging DS books among themselves, this is for arranging CS books from themselves, and this is to arrange the 3 subjects amongst themselves. So the result will be equal to 6 factorial into 4 factorial into 3 factorial into 3 factorial. The next sub question is, only the DS books must be together. So these are the DS books, 4 books, and rest of the books are here, maths books, CS books. Now maths and CS books can be mixed up with each other, so we'll consider each book as a separate unit. So there are total 9 books over here. All DS books must be kept together, so we'll consider this all DS books as a single unit, so which will be equal to the 10th unit or 10th book. Now these 10 books can be arranged themselves by using 10P10, that is 10 factorial, and these DS books can be arranged amongst themselves by 4P4 ways. So total number of ways equal to 10 factorial multiplied by 4 factorial. This is all about the permutation, and we have just now seen the examples of the category when all objects are distinct. In my next video, we'll see the other categories of the problems. I hope you liked my video. If you really like my video, press like button given below the video. If you have any queries, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video.